Okay, we're going to do another quick tutorial for Adobe Animate. And this time we're going to look at how we can rotate elements. So I am starting off, I am in my website folder, the Project 2 demo folder with, and I have created, or we've been working in this Adobe Animate folder in there because we've got some folder in there. So working in the Adobe Animate folder. Here, there's a rolling elements folder that I have supplied to you. So if you go look in that one, you see that there's an original images folder. So these are just some images I've gathered off the internet to give us kind of a starting point. So the new project I'm going to create, I'm going to save here. But there's also some files I've just given you. So let's jump over to Animate. I'm going to create a new HTML5 document. Okay, let's see. It's 550 by 400 pixels. We can stick with that. Maybe we'll change my frame rate to 30 per second. And actually, I was thinking about changing my stage color to light gray. I just want it to be something different than the white that shows in the browser when I'm testing that. Okay. So here we go. We've got a good starting point. Actually, I'm going to go save as well. So this is going to be elements. Okay. To demo, animate, rolling elements. Okay, rotating or rolling, either way. So rotating elements.fl. Save. Okay, there we go. Got my file all set up. So the first thing I'm going to do is I want to come up to the file menu. And I want to import to the stage. So in that folder that I gave you, I left some images out. And folder again, real quick. So in that folder, I was looking at some cars and some wheels and some things like that, and I ended up coming with, so there's some different things here. I found this Porsche that I actually stripped the wheels from the body, and so I thought, we'll make the wheels rotate on this. Obviously not rotate. So I'm going to go grab the Porsche wheel right here, double click it, and pop it out here. Stage. Okay, so first I have a wheel. So I want the wheels to rotate. So that would be the first thing to do. So once I have that wheel on the stage, I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to come down and convert that to a symbol. So I am going to call this rotating wheel. Okay, because that's where the animation goes. It actually goes in this point right here. So now I'm going to double click on that one, and now you see up here at the top that I'm working in rotating wheels. So that's where the end to be. So I want this to rotate. So I'm going to right click on it, and up at the top you see that we can create a motion tween. So I want to do a motion tween for this one. So I'm going to select that, and then it brings up this dialog box saying that the selected item cannot be tweened. You must convert this to a symbol in order to tween. Do you want to convert and create a tween? So let's go ahead and say OK. And if I look in my library, you see that it has named it symbol 1. So I'm just going to go call this wheel. Okay. Now I'm still working in the rotating wheel here. Okay. So with that there, I actually need to make the change on it now. So make sure I've got it selected. And if I look down here in my timeline, I'm going to go down and you see it has picked the 30 mark right here. Okay. When I select that right there in my timeline, I can now come over into properties and you see there's ease and there's rotation and so forth. I want rotation and I'm going to go to degree. And since 360 degrees is a full circle, I'm going to go 359. So it's going to go all the way up to the end of it, and then it'll, start over on the next rotation. So make that be 359. So now across 30 frames, which is 1 second, it's going to do one full rotation. Okay. So we could go preview this thing real quick. Let's go do a quick test. And now we just see that our wheel is spinning. So that's good. We've got a good start going right there. Okay, coming back in here. Okay, so now I have one of them. I really should do a second wheel. So I could go to the library and I could get rotating wheel and I could drag it out again. So let's go back to scene one. Let's drag another rotating wheel out here. Okay. So now I've got using shift as I drag that over so that they're aligned with each other. And so now if I go test, I have two rotating wheels. So good start. My car needed two wheels, so that's good. You know what, I haven't saved. No, I did save. I saved initially. Let's do a quick save, though. Make sure I'm saving as I go. Okay, so now I have these two elements, each one rotating. So I'm working with one layer. I ought to name my layer down here. Actually, what I'm in here, this is always good to name my layers. I was forgetting to do that as I went. Okay, go back out to scene one. There's my rotating wheels. So, now the other thing I was thinking about was actually making this move across the page. So, if I want to do that, I want these two elements that have animations in them to move together from this point on. But not only do I want them to move together, I also want there to be a car body now going with them. So I'm going to come down here to my layers in the timeline and create a new layer. Name it car body. Okay. It actually needs to go below the wheels, so I drag it down below the wheels. We'll go to file, import to stage. Okay, there's my Porsche body right there. And there's my Porsche body. So see if I can figure out the placement. Obviously, my wheels are not in a great spot. Okay. There we go. It looks a little better. Maybe the body needs to go down to here. There we go. Okay, so I have my wheels, which spin, and I have my Porsche body sitting there. If we want to double check it, we come up here and test again, but they should just sit there with spinning wheels. There we go. It doesn't go anywhere, but that's okay. And now because I want this to move together, I'm going to grab all of those elements right there. I'm going to right click and convert this to a symbol. Okay, so we're just going to call this car and say okay. So this is now the whole car is the element that I want to have move across the page now. So that's what I'm going to work on. So let's go back down here to my timeline. We're just going to do create a classic tween now. We use the motion tween when the wheels were spinning because you actually have to see the wheels spinning. So we want to get that level of detail there. Classic tween, we're just going to pick the beginning point and the end point. So I'm going to say create a classic tween. Let's see, let's go to, how long do we want to take it across the screen? Let's go to 90 seconds out here. And let's put a keyframe out here, okay? So, going back to the beginning, I'll take my car and move it off of the screen out here, off the left edge. Then I'm going to come down here and drag it to the right edge, so it runs off the page. So it starts there, and I hit play, and we watch it go across the screen. Now, I can't see my wheels turning, but they should be working. Let's go double check, do a test, and there it goes, driving across the screen with the wheels turning. And it's just going to go endlessly like this, unless I go tell it to stop at some point. So Anyway, that's working pretty well for us right there. So now we have put everything in place to not only make the individual wheels spin, group a couple of those together, add the car body, and then add a tween to all of that so the whole thing moves across the page. So that's how we can use that. So interesting to see what other interesting uses you come up with as you start to play with it.